Good morning, friends. So again we will see the next question given in your assignment number 2. The question number 3. This question is from chapter 13, Multiprocessor, from Maurice Mano textbook. Now let us see what it says. As the name suggests, multiprocessors. Now, to speed up the computation or for the large number of floating point operation, sometimes it is required to club up multiple processors or coprocessor within the same system. Now, if this is the case, then how do you connect them with a memory? So there are two major concepts. Either all the processors are tightly coupled or all the processors are loosely coupled. Now, what is there in tightly coupled processor? In tightly coupled processor, all the CPUs are there having their internal cache memory, but they all are sharing the common memory unit known as a shared memory unit. Now, who will access the memory first, who will share the data first, that determines by the multiple interconnection strategies. Now let us go to the second type of the multiprocessor system. It is loosely coupled multiprocessor system. Now what is there in loosely coupled system? Loosely coupled system is a type of a distributed computing system. What is the logic? There are n number of CPUs and each CPU are provided with their local memory. Now all the CPU can communicate with other CPU by a message passing unit. So as all the CPUs are having their own memory, they can work out in their local memory. Only if they require the data of next CPU, then they will communicate. Now again, who will share the data first, who will request the data first, that depends upon the various interconnection strategy. So today we are going to discuss the question number 3, that was on various multiprocessor interconnection system. So what we are going to connect? We are going to connect set of n processor with a available set of common memory as well as with a local memory and between all the processors. So very first strategy is the common bus, system bus structure for multiprocessor. Now you can see in the diagram we have 3 setup. Very first is the CPU number 1. It is available with its local memory. It is having one input output processor and it is having this system bus interface, that is SBI. Now this is a one set of processor. There is a second set of processor available in the same motherboard. The CPU, second CPU, the local memory of second CPU, input output processor head for the second CPU and the system bus interface for the second CPU. Similarly, there is a third entity, CPU number 3, the local memory associated with it, input output processor or controller with that CPU and system bus interface SBI for that. Now there are 3 different entities, so they are forming a multiprocessor system. So common bus system says that let us provide a common bus between them so that they can pass message to each other. Now you can see that all of them are connected with their local memory. So this is a local memory, local bus connected. So this setup one is connected with a local bus. What is the role of local bus? To transfer the data from local memory to CPU 1. From CPU 1 to bus controller. From CPU 1 to input output processor. Similarly, these two CPUs are also connected with a local bus. Now, they all are connected with a common bus, system bus. Now, if CPU 2 wants the data of CPU 1, then CPU 2 will put a request over here. That is, it will receive the data and CPU 1 has to put the data over here. Now, suppose this communication is happening and CPU 3 is coming in a picture and this CPU wants the data of CPU 1. Now you can see these two entities are already communicating. CPU 3 will be in a waiting state. So what is the disadvantage of this system? One cannot decide the priority. Second, there will be a system in a waiting state. Third,
the overall speed of the data communication is always in the reduced manner as your channel may be occupied. And the last problem with this structure is that if no one is sending the data, but still they have to sense the channel every time, that is the bus free? If it is free, then they can start with the communication. So the solution to this are these two techniques. Let us see the second one. Multi-port system. Now over here, all the memory units available are available over here. Memory 1 unit, memory 2, memory 3, memory 4. Suppose I have a 4 memory units. Parallelly, I have a 4 CPUs. Now, each memory is connected with each CPU. Like memory 1 is connected with CPU 1 with this port. Memory 1 is connected with CPU 2 with this port. Memory 1 is connected with CPU 3 with this port. And memory 1 is connected with CPU 4 with this port. Now, what is the advantage of this system? Every CPU is independent of each other and they can read and write the data of memory 1 parallelly. Now, the question is, if some CPU is writing the data, then parallelly second CPU cannot read. So, there will be again a small level of waiting state. Same type of port system is available with memory 2, 3 and 4. Now, what is the problem over here? The CPUs are arranged with a hierarchy, with their priority. So, if CPU 1 is accessing memory 1, then CPU 2, if it wants to access the memory 2, it will be in a halting state. Because the processors are connected in a priority order. CPU 1 possess the highest priority, CPU 4 possess the lower priority. So again, this structure is facing the delay due to the priority. And you can see there are multiple complex configurations. So if you configure the same system with a LogiSim simulator, you can see that each port is nothing but a kind of a connection. So can we solve this problem by the second solution? The crossbar switch is removing all the limitation of multi-port system, and how it will provide a small multiplexers over here available with a priority encoder. Now again the design is same. In the schematic, all the memory units are available over here. All the CPUs as per their priority are available over here. But now, this instead of this memory level port connection, you have a switch, crossbar switch. That is exactly your multiplexer. Now, what this multiplexer will do? If CPU 1 wants to access the memory 1, then priority of that CPU is evaluated. And if no other CPU is demanding memory 1, then connection of CPU 1 to memory 1 will be established. And they will read and write the data. But if two CPUs are requesting to access the same memory, then priority encoder will halt a second CPU. But it will allow the highest priority CPU to access the memory. So this will resolve the problem that if any CPU is reading or writing the data, then second will be in a waiting state. Now, what is the main advantage of this system? Instead of this port-wise connection or this token-based system, it will work on the multiplexer-based thing. So, multiplexer will be again having the same design. If you have a particular selection line, that CPU will be selected. And who will generate that selection line? A priority encoder. So, only one complex hardware we are adding over here is the priority encoder. That is nothing but the reverse of your decoder unit. So rest two strategy we will discuss next. They are hypercube and a multi-level switch. So I hope you got the idea. Thank you for listening.